Craig Adams here of Kenham's Media and WeddingFilmSchool.com, and today I'm just going to teach you how to build one of these WordPress theme website using a template. They're wonderful for filmmakers, and I've had some really good success with building websites using these themes. So the first thing you do is you register yourself at WordPress.com. Just sign in, make a new account, create a blog, whatever you want it to be, and it's probably going to have the .wordpress.com after it. That's okay. So once you get that set up, we're going to move over and buy the theme. So themeforest.net is a wonderful website for buying these templates for WordPress. Make sure you click WordPress, popular items. These are a lot of really cool designs, and the cost is about $40 to $60. So it's really not that bad for a one-time price for your website design. These are really good. It's not that bad. So find one you like, buy it, download it, and then just put that zip file. It should be one file on your desktop. So once you do that, you're going to go over, what I use is GoDaddy. So GoDaddy is just like a domain and web hosting site. It's one of the most popular. So make a new account. And you're going to search for your domain. Just make sure that you get the .com. It's probably what you're looking for, but it depends. You might want a .net or something else. So once you find the domain that you want, add it and buy it for the amount of time you need. 2 years is usually good. 5 years is probably smarter, but once you do that, that's good. So next, you're going to buy web hosting. So this is the last thing that you have to buy. So Economy and Deluxe are really the two options here. This is for if you want one website, and or you can buy Deluxe if you think you're going to have multiple websites. So I started with Economy, and I just recently moved to Deluxe because I've got like three websites. So this is probably the smarter decision, but most people will start with just one website. So Economy is probably best. So once you buy that, you're just going to, and usually you want to buy like the same amount of time as your domain, just to make things easy. So go to your account for GoDaddy here. And what you're going to do is you're actually going to launch this web hosting app. And the first thing you're going to do once you get to this page is you're going to go to hosted domains here. And for you, there should be nothing here. So you're going to add a domain, you're just going to type the name of your website, and as you start, it should show you a field. So click that field, leave this blank with that, backslash, yeah. Hit OK, and then it should take a couple minutes to set up, give it like a half an hour or so, just keep refreshing it every so often. Once you have that, it should have your website.com, and then have this backslash, and then set up. So what you're going to do next is you're going to go back to hosting, and GoDaddy actually works with WordPress and has an app that makes this whole process very easy. So what you're going to do next is click application, install WordPress, and again, you should have nothing there if you haven't done this yet. You're going to select whatever domain you're using. It's going to show this in the directory, and you're going to actually leave this blank again. You're going to type in a new username, word password, and then your email address. Make sure that's all correct and these are the same. Hit OK, and then give that some time to process as well. But once it's done, it'll send you an email to that address that you put into the contact field. And it'll tell you that your WordPress is ready. So that means the app is installed, but sometimes it's not even ready yet. So if you click this and it doesn't send you to the WordPress login, that's okay. Just give it some more time. And I'm already logged in, so this is where it'll send you after you click OK after the login. So this is the dashboard for WordPress. And you'll notice that it has your website.com/wp-admin. So you'll just go to your website if you just type fresh, like your website.com, and this is the website. But if you type this /wp-admin/, it'll send you to this dashboard. So this is where you change and you manipulate and build your website. So this is your website, but we don't have the new theme that we bought yet. So we're going to install that by going back to GoDaddy. We're going to go up here to Files and FTP, File Manager. And once we get here, this is kind of like where your files sit for your website. So this is just like an online cloud-based file system. And under Webroot, you have all these files that the WordPress app already made. And for you, you won't have this because this is another website and this is another website, but you'll have all three of these and then these files up here. So the main important one is the WP content. You're going to click that, go down to themes, click the theme folder to bring it up over here. And you'll notice I have these folders of different WordPress themes that I've installed. So what you're going to do is you're going to upload, add file, and you're actually going to upload the zip. Make sure it's the .zip file that you downloaded from WordPress, or you downloaded from ThemeForest. So yeah, it's going to upload, it should be a small file, just a one. So yeah, this is the theme from ThemeForest that I want to put on my website. And once we have this uploaded into our themes folder, under WP content, under the Webroot, we're going to click it. Wait for it. Yeah, we're gonna click it and extract it. So that should take another couple of seconds as well. There we go. Click it, hit more, extract. So this is actually extracting the zip file. Make sure that's all right. So that sends the files into this area right here. So it's right here. It just made that file. We don't need this anymore. We can delete that. And then you should be all set with GoDaddy then. So get rid of that. Go back to your dashboard. You're going to go down to appearance, theme. It might take some time, but you're going to be able to see the new theme that you downloaded. You're just going to click activate. And that means it's importing your theme as your main theme for your website. So then it's all set. You can go to whatever options your theme, because every theme is different. You can change all these different options. You can make pages, set menus, and your plugins and everything. So that's when you start to build your website and really take charge and build whatever you want. So if you have any comments or questions, or if you have your own website that you want to show off that you built using this method, please leave a comment below. But until then, thank you for watching. See ya.